Christians, I love you. Your friends and your family will not remember your best words. They will remember your worst. So when you're at Thanksgiving dinner, listen to me, there's more at stake than whatever's happening politically. There's more at stake in whatever's happening publicly. What's happening for eternity is the most important thing. And you are not standing for Jesus by insulting someone with your political opinion. James says this, understand this, my dear brothers and sisters. Understand this. Why? We don't understand it. You all, pray about, if that's you, you all. You're like, I don't know if it's you. You all must be quick to listen. Do the math. God gave you two ears and one mouth. You must all be quick to listen and slow to speak. Come on now, all my social justice warriors, my Instagrammers, my tweeters. I got to get my opinion out there, do you? Or could you step back? Could you pray? Could you relax? Think about what's happening this week. Think about the social media storm, because something's been leaked. We don't even know if it's true. And we're already on our side, your side, ready to kill each other over something that hasn't even been released. Interesting. Well, they're not following the Lord. Let them speak. We're commanded to be slow to speak, quick to listen, and slow to get angry. Okay? What do you need to do if you're angry? You need to calm yourself down. You need to calm yourself down. There's going to be enough anger on Judgment Day. The Lord's got it. He's good. He's good. And your anger is going to do nothing good in your life. And by the way, I think we're all getting played by both sides and every side just to get angry so we watch their stupid channels. I honestly think our media wants this country to burn down just so they can get viewers. They don't care at all about our neighborhoods, our schools, our kids. They care about ratings. And we need to remember that. Next, as a Christian, again, as a Christian, I need to learn to speak the truth lovingly. And somebody's like, that's what I'm doing, Pastor, speaking the truth in love. Well, tell your face, right? Your face does not spell love, you know? You ever seen those marches in the name of love? They're all so angry. Like, can you imagine? You ever seen these marches in the name of love? You're like, oh, if I go there, I'm getting beat up, you know? It's like, that's not, okay, just because you write love on your poster doesn't mean you have it in your heart. So Ephesians 4:15 says this, instead we will speak the truth in love, growing in every way more and more like Christ. I was talking to one of our pastors this week, and this is what he said. He said, Matt, the public me doesn't need to change. He said, it's the private me. I was like, ooh. We all have to be so careful. We all have to be so careful. And some of you are like, well, Pastor, what's your view on Roe v. Wade? My view's always been the same. I care about the kids. I think abortion's wrong. I don't know how many times more do I need to say that? But I also care about the moms. I care about the young women. I care about these poor ladies that find themselves in a situation where they don't know what to do. I care about both. So I got to be careful that I don't get caught up in a tennis match between two parties that just want to be elected. That's all they care about. And so we got to be really, really careful what we say. We got to be really, really careful how we say it. Because our tone may win us an argument and lose a soul for all eternity.